That's right, Scareluria. See, I'm a monster, and I'm practicing being scary. Come on.
Shh. Oh, excuse me?
Did I scare you, Maria? Huh? Did I?
No, actually, you surprised me. You see, I wasn't expecting you to jump out at me like that, and that's what a surprise is, when something happens that you're not expecting.
I didn't want to surprise you. I wanted to scare you.
Why did you want to scare me?
Because I'm a monster. That's what monsters do. You do want me to be the best monster I can be, don't you?
Yes, I want you to be a great little monster. But this really isn't a good time for you to practice how to be a monster. You know, I'll never get this clock fixed or all that wobble, wobble, wobble going on.
Okay, Maria, I won't try to scare you anymore.
Okay, good. You surprised me again. I thought you weren't going to try to scare me anymore.
I wasn't trying to scare you. I was trying to scare me. I need all the practice I can get. Ooh, that was pretty scary, don't you think? Ooh, very good. I'm getting good.
This looks like a good time for a coffee break.
Very scary.
Surprise.
Goodness gracious me, twiddle daughter Tina, dearest. What a beautiful day. I am so glad I brought my beach umbrella so I can sit in the sand in the cool shade.
That's nice, twiddle dad. Nice for you. But I do not have a beach umbrella to sit under. Do you have one, twiddle brother Timmy?
No, I don't.
Do you have a beach umbrella, Twiddle Mommy?
Oh, me? Oh, my. I certainly do not. I guess all of us, except you, my Twiddle dearest husband, will have to sit out in the hot, hot sun.
Yes, I guess so.
No, wait. Huh? I think I have a better way, my Twiddle family.
You do, Twiddle dearest daughter? Pray, tell us what is that way?
We could cooperate and share the umbrella.
Share the umbrella?
Yes.
It sounds daring, daughter darling, but I think we should try it.
It's working! Yay!
Yes! And soon we can all go for a swim in the ocean!
Yay!
Twiddle Dad, I have just one question to ask you before we go for a swim in the ocean.
And what is that, Tina, my darling dear?
Where exactly is the ocean?
Huh? The ocean? Why, it's, there? No, there? No, where is it?
I don't know. It must be around here somewhere.
I don't see anything around here.
Look over this way. You look over that way.
Maybe.
It's gotta be around here somewhere.
Twelve. 13.
recess, and me and my friend went on the horses.
Come on, Silver!
Swung for a while. Then we decided to go on the monkey bars. I didn't used to know that I was blind. It's just like keeping your eyes closed all the time. And that I didn't understand it. Now I know.
Where did you go to your reader? Turn to page 145. Sylvia?
Once upon a time, an old gray fisherman lived in an old gray hut beside an old gray sea.
Would you like to continue from there?
I shall keep this mackerel and fry it for my own, for my dinner. The old man.
I read with my fingers. I put my fingers on some dots, and then I go over the dots, and they're put in different ways. And then the way that they are, that's the letter.
It's time for some math review. Try to see if you can get the first row done in 5 minutes. In a little while, we'll
I add by using an abacus. Let's say the question was 2 plus 2. I put 2 beads down from the right row, and then I put another 2 beads down, and then I got 4. That's all I had. I come home from school on the bus. The bus takes me to our farm. I live on a farm in Manitoba. And play organ, that's an instrument, and that's music. And I just think of some music, and I try playing it and see if I can remember it. My dog, Lassie, he came to me as a puppy, and he's really very playful. I really like, I'd say, playing with my cousin. My cousin, his brother had 3 sheep, and then they got lambs, and then one of the lambs is called Jumpy. I like to feed my rabbit. You could try something to see if you're blind. Just close your eyes all the time, and you figure out what it means to be blind. It's just like couldn't see a thing, or having your eyes closed like you're sleeping, but you're not asleep.
Surprise!
Yeah.
away my hat. It's really windy today. My, what a wind. There. Oh, no, no. Oh, dear, not again.
The wind is very, very strong.
You can say that again.
Talk like that. Indians talk just like that on TV, didn't they, Rip?
Right.
Well, no matter what you saw on TV with all those Uggs and me want'ems, I'm telling you, Indians don't talk like that.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do you know?
I'm an Indian.
Oh.
You know, there are all kinds of creatures in the world, and they're all good in different ways. And a frog is a proud one to be.
Yes, Mr. Plummet.
And just so you don't forget, here is an old frog folk song from Scotland.
Oh.
That I learned when I was about as small as you are now.
Wow.
And it goes like this. The nightingale sings such a beautiful tune. You can listen all night by the light of the moon. Now my song's not as pretty, but I'll say it again. I am proud to be one of the frogs in the glen. The butterfly is such a colorful thing, with an orange and yellow and black on its wing. Now I'm only green, but I'll say it again. I am proud to be one of the frogs in the glen. The deer can jump higher, the fish can swim faster than ever a froggy swam. But a deer can't dive deep, and a fish can't re-beep. So I'm proud to be what I am. Be proud of your flippers and the flies you can catch, and the logs that you leap and the eggs you will hatch. We're under the stars and we're smaller than men, but I'm proud to be one of the frogs in the glen. Now sing it with me and we'll say it again. I am proud to be one of the frogs in the glen.
Always be proud of what you are, a frog.
Okay, Mr. Kermit.
I used to make a picture of my friend Amelia.
I am so sorry I scared you before, Mary.
Oh, that's okay, Prairie. Hey, do you think maybe, possibly, you could show me how you did it? I want to be able to be just as scary as you.
Well, actually, it was pretty simple. I simply waved my arms and went...
Wow! And you're not even a monster!
No.
Wow! Is this how you did it?
Oh, my! Whoa! Oh, yes. Yes, that was very, very scary.
Aw, thanks, Prairie.
You're welcome.
You know what? I think I'm going to try it out on someone. I know. I'll scare Buckley.
Mary scared Buckley.
Yay, I did it. I scared Buckley. Yay.
Linda's right. That wasn't nice. Look how scared Buckley is. Poor fella.
Gee, I didn't know he'd get that scared. What should I do? I like Barkley. I don't want him to be scared of me.
You can show him that he doesn't have to be afraid of you by talking softly to him.
Oh, okay. Barkley. It's okay, Barkley. Don't be scared. It's okay. Come here, boy. Come on. Yeah, come on. It's okay. Good boy. You can come here. Oh, good boy. Huh? Don't be scared. It's okay. Don't be scared. Okay. Good boy.
Linda says you can try to pet him.
Oh, okay. Good dog. You don't have to be scared of me. Come on. You don't have to be scared.
Yeah. I don't think Barkley's afraid of you anymore.
You know, I kind of like not being scary. Barkley.
I'd like to tell you a poem I wrote about the dogs in my neighborhood.
Flat dog, square dog, round dog rolls. Earth dog, space dog, star dog bowls. Big dog, little dog, giant dog barks. Old dog, young dog, long dog parks. Fast dog, slow dog, happy dog flies. Black dog, white dog, blue dog cries. Tall dog, short dog, scared dog creeps. Quiet dog, noisy dog, tired dog sleep. I guess we should let sleeping dogs lie.
And now, the Sesame Street Country Music Festival presents Miss Hammy Swinette and her trash can.
Sometimes it's hard to be a trash can when folks get bigger each day. They throw their trash down, they throw it all around, but no one's throwing it away. This is a park, it ain't no pigsty.
Dr. Nancy Einstein unravels the mysteries of the ice cube. Where does it come from? Where does it go? Nancy Einstein puts ice cubes everywhere. She put one on the windowsill, she put one in her pocket, and one down her brother's back. She put one in the freezer, one in the wash, and one in a flower pot. By that time, her hands were so cold that she decided to stop. But when she went to get her ice cubes later, they were gone. All gone, except for the one in the freezer. Nancy Einstein learned something that day. Never put ice cubes down your brother's back.
Jackson, they feed the elk because it's too snowy up there for them, and it just gets too cold for the weak ones, so they all come down to the feeding area, and they just sort of like feed cows, sort of like when you feed cows, they just like they feed an elk and stuff.
All right, this will be take 11. Iron. Thank you very much.
Here's a song about Jellyman Kelly. He loves jelly the most. Papa, most of all, Jellyman Kelly loves jelly on toast. Here's a part about Jenny Mulhenny. She's a fireman's daughter. Yeah, but most of all, Jenny Mulhenny loves to boil hot water. So Jenny put the kettle on. Jelly man, Kelly, can he come home? Jenny, can he come? Jenny put the kettle on. Jelly man, Kelly, can he come home? Jenny, can he come? Come home, Jenny, can he come? Yada, 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 voodoo, papa. A yodely hoo, da ba da ba doo doo. Yaka, 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 ha, ha, no. That's a story about Jellyman Kelly. He sure loves jelly. And yes, and maybe someday you and me, friend, we can have tea with him. One more time.
Ah, Jelly, come home, Jelly, Jelly, come home, Jelly, Jelly, come. Ah, Jelly, come home, Jelly, Jelly, come home, Jelly, Jelly, come.
Waiter,
Mr. Monster?
Waiter, I'd like to order...
One moment. Yes, sir, I'm ready now. What can I do for you?
Yes, I'd like a bowl of chicken soup, please.
Very good choice. You've been here before, haven't you? I'll be right back. One bowl of chicken soup, Charlie!
That settles it. I don't know why I keep coming back to this place. This guy gives me a hard time every time I come in here. If it's not one thing, it's another.
Here, Charlie. Okay, sir. Here we have your delicious chicken soup.
Yes. Waiter!
Yes, sir.
I can't eat this soup.
You can't eat this soup like it? Oh, of course not. I can feel it. It is too cold. I will get you another bowl of soup. I'm sorry, sir. Hey, Charlie, how about a hot bowl this time, okay? Give the guy a break.
Well, that settles it. From now on, I'm bringing my lunch to work in a paper sack.
Okay, Charlie, I think you'll be happy this time. There you are, sir.
Now, I...
Have a good and hearty meal.
Yes, but... Waiter!
Oh, I bet it's too hot now. Okay, I'll blow on for you.
The problem is, you
there,
see, you forgot to bring...
Well, I forgot the salt, didn't I? Of course. The pepper.
No.
The crackers.
No.
Well, then tell me, why can't you eat the soup, sir?
Why don't you taste it?
Oh, all right, sir. The customer is always right. I shall taste it. Mm-hmm. Where's the spoon?
Aha!
Oh, I forgot the spoon. Oh!
You can't eat soup without a spoon.
So sorry, sir.
Wow.
There's the spoon.
Now.
Next time, when you want the spoon, ask for one.
One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13.
So this is a library! Whoa! Look at all these books! I never saw anything like this in the jungle!
Chicago's never been to a library before. Linda says you should look around, see what you want. If you can't find it, she'll help you.
Okay!
Okay.
Thanks!
Chicago! No! Chicago, what are you doing up there? Come down here this instant.
But I'm hunting.
Says he's hunting. Oh, no. Don't worry. He's a vegetarian lion. He only hunts for vegetables. Chicago, there are no vegetables in the library, only books.
Yeah, I know. But I'm hunting for a book about vegetables. Yeah, see, I like reading about vegetables almost as much as I like eating them. Let's see.
He said he's looking for a book about vegetables. No, Chicago.
No.
Oh, Chicago. No, wait. No, Chicago.
None there.
No. Look, Linda said if you just come down here, she'll help you find the book that you're looking for. She's a librarian. That's what she's here for.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, Linda. But I think I see a vegetable book now.
Chicago, don't! Jump. Linda, do you have any books about lion taming?
It was an unusual case, that's for sure. A snake had come into my office because he had lost his end. He had a beginning, that's his head, and he had a middle, all knotted up. But his end was nowhere to be found. I took out my magnifying glass and it became clear what we had to do. Follow his coils. They were the only clue we had. The beginning of the snake followed me. His middle trailed behind. The snake's coils lay on the wrong side of the tracks in a rough part of town. But that didn't scare me. Through a dingy alley and down a dark staircase they lay. Then straight into a nightclub. I was prepared for the worst. Inside, the band whooped it up while the coils danced with the crowd. I looked back at the snake's beginning. This looks like the place. His middle bounced up and down, excited. The coils led to the bandstand, and there, playing the drums, was the snake's end. Now we knew where the snake's beginning was, also his middle, and finally his end. They were together again at last, and that is the case's end.
Oh. Oh. No. Oh. Look
Ernie,
at that.
Ernie, what are you watching?
Oh, it's a great old movie, Bert.
What is it?
Oh, it's called... It's just Cowboys in Outer Space, Bert. Ooh. Look
Ernie,
at that.
Ernie, can't you do something else besides watch TV? I mean, you've been watching TV all day long.
Like what, Bert? I mean, it's raining outside, Bert.
Well, I know it's raining, but Ernie, there are other things to do inside besides watching TV.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, like what, Bert?
What?
Look at that.
Oh.
Those are just actors.
Yeah, okay,
Bert.
I'm trying to think what else you can do.
Did you see that one, Bert?
How about reading? You can read. We got a lot of books here.
Reading? Well, I don't know, Bert. I don't particularly feel like reading right now, Bert.
Oh, well. How about writing a story? Hey, that's good, Ernie. Writing a story. Yeah.
Writing a story?
Wouldn't that be fun? You can write your very own story.
Writing a story?
Yeah.
That's a pretty good idea, Bert.
Yeah.
Hey, Bert, would you help me if I were to write a story? Would you help me?
Well, yeah, I suppose I could give you ideas. I'll help you, sure. Yeah.
Oh, okay, great.
Great. Terrific. Wow, no TV set on all day long. Oh, great.
Hey, Bert.
Huh?
Can you give me a hand?
A hand? What do you want?
Okay,
Ernie?
Bert. Come on, Bert.
What are you doing?
Oh, we're writing a story, Bert.
This is not writing a story.
Well, it's the first stage, Bert. It's planning to write a story, Bert. So you can't just sit down and write a story. You have to plan to write it. And that's what I'm doing. You see? Now, we've got paper. I'll take that paper, Bert. See, we have the paper to write on. And I have pencils right here to write with, Bert. And then I have my handy-dandy pencil sharpener. And I have my eraser here. For any mistakes I might make, Bert, see, I can erase them.
Uh-huh.
And then I have a waste paper basket to put it in. A waste paper basket. Bert, have you seen my waste paper basket?
Ask me that again and look into my eyes.
Oh, Bert, have you seen my waste... Oh, this is my waste paper basket,
Bert. Of course, it's your waste basket!
Oh, yes.
You put it on my head!
Oh, thank you, Bert.
Thank you.
No, that's my waste paper basket for throwing stuff in when I make a mistake, you
Terrific.
See.
Terrific. Mm-hmm. Okay, now, Ernie.
What?
You have planned your whole adventure in writing a story.
That's
true. You planned everything out to the last detail.
Right.
All planned.
Right.
Okay, go to it.
Okay, I'll see you around.
Whoa, wait. Well, where are you going?
I'm going to go play outside in the puddles.
But why?
Well, you see, Bert, I can't think of anything to write right now, Bert. But when I do think of something, I have it all planned. And I, thanks to you, Bert, I couldn't have planned it without you.
Beep, beep. Beep, beep. Some of the words that begin with I, they get to be quite tricky, like intersection and illegal, irritate and icky. Many words that begin with I are longer than itchy and into. There's impossible and incredible and important too. The letter I is quite a pip. I think I'll take him on my trip. We'll have some fun and do a flip. Into my car away we'll zip. I'm glad to be with the letter I, 'cause he's so irresistible.
Beep beep.
Down, 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 down.
Bah. Bah. Bah.
Okay, you guys, now listen up. Tell me, who's afraid of the big bad wolf? What? You mean no one's afraid of the big bad wolf? Well, I really find that very difficult to believe. Oh, come. Somebody must be afraid of the big bad wolf. No?
I'm reading this book here about a pioneer who rode his horse all over the old frontier. Can read a book, something you can read. A good book is all you need, and you can read.
In this magazine, I read about a queen who likes to bounce all day on a trampoline. Can read a magazine, you can read a magazine's all you need, then you can read.
In the newspaper I just read about a guy who ate 1,000 pieces of pumpkin pie. Can read a newspaper, you can read a newspaper's all you need, and you can read.
I'm reading this book here about a pioneer.
I read a magazine over about the old frontier.
In my newspaper, I just read about a guy who ate a book,
something you can read.
Pumpkin pie.
A good book is all you need.
And you, paper you can read. A newspaper's all you need. And you can read.
Read a book.
Newspaper.
It's great when you can read.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shy. Oh, but I want to.
Could
I play? Oh, no. Oh, why did I say that? Now I'm so embarrassed. Oh, they're going to look at me. I know they're going. Oh, no, they're coming over. I don't know what to say.
Come over and play with us. It's a great idea.
Play with you? Well, I'd like to, but I. Oh, I don't know. I don't. I'm not really sure. I've never. I could try, but I.
Throw away
from me. Well, okay, here. I could. Oh!
Look at that vegetable book Gordon's reading. The broccoli from another planet. Whoa! I want to read that.
Chicago, what are you doing?
What?
I'm reading this book.
Yeah. But I caught it. It's mine. That's the law of the jungle.
This is not a jungle. It's a library. We take turns here.
Take turns?
Right. You can read this book as soon as I'm done with it, okay?
Sounds fair. Done yet?
Almost. I've got one more page.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Hey. Okay, now it's all yours.
Okay, great. Now just put it down right here, yeah.
Why?
I want to catch it.
You don't have to catch it. I'm giving it to you.
Yeah. But it's more fun to catch it. Put it down right here. Yeah, right there. Gotcha. Now I'll read you.
Turkey's in the straw, turkey's in the straw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Turkey's in the hay, turkey's in the hay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Turkey's in the tree, turkey's in the tree. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Yes, sir. 13.
3,409 sheep. 3,410 sheep. 3,411 sheep. What? My sheep? Where are my sheep?
Your sheep, my friend, are tired of jumping. Every night it's the same thing. Jump, jump, jump. Count. Well, we are tired of jumping. We've had it. Sheep need sleep too, you know.
Oh, this is terrible. Oh, I have no more sheep to count. And counting is what I love to do. I've already counted all my bats. I've counted the flowers on the bedspread. The spots on my pajamas. Oh, but wait. Not to panic. Ah, yes. Here it is. 24-hour emergency counting service. We deliver. The number, yes. Okay. Yes. Hello? Yes, operator. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, please. I love that number. Somehow it has a certain ring to it.
24-hour emergency counting service.
Yes. This is the count. I need somebody to count in a hurry. My goodness, that is a hurry. Come in.
What seems to be the problem?
Oh, I've run out of sheep to count.
Well, I got just a thing for you. Yeah, we're running a special on Swiss cheese. Count the holes, sleep like a baby.
Oh, that's not enough for me to count. I am the count.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Look, I guarantee, you count all the paper clips in this jar, you'll be snoring in dreamland in no time.
Oh, I'd finish those in no time. No, it's not enough. I really need, what I really want, is more sheep to count.
More sheep? More sheep. They always want more sheep. I was afraid of this. Okay, buddy, you just get a little comfy and cozy in your little bed. I'll be right back.
I can hardly wait to start counting sheep again.
Bah.
Well, it's not perfect, but it'll have to do.
Oh, boy, I hate this. Bah!
One pretend sheep.
Bah!
That's two pretend sheep. That's three pretend sheep.
Bah!
Four pretend sheep.
Bah!
Five pretend sheep.
It's not an easy way to make a living.
Six pretend sheep. He's getting tired. Seven pretend sheep. Oh, I love it.
One shell. Two big shells. Three shells. Four shells. Five shells. Now he's closing it up.
He's going up.
He's going up to the surface. Now he's up.
He's opening the bag.
Taking out one shell. And he's putting them in on the beach. Two shells. Three shells. Four shells. Shells.
Crab! Ouchie!
Oh, Calcutta Joe was a modern rhino who swung sweet and low on his mellow oboe. While Flo the hippo stood up on her big toe and spun her yo-yo way up high and down low. A crow and her beau flew in from Ohio and danced the fandango in the meadow below. The crows, the hippo, and Calcutta Joe all stood in a row and sang fo-dee-o-do. And together they sang
fo-dee-o-do.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Dion.
Dion who?
Dion, you!
D. Danger. Dragon. Doctor. Dinner. Dessert. D.
okay. He's a friendly lion. He's friendly. He's friendly. Everyone, friendly lion. He's friendly.
Oh, yeah.
Chicago. Hmm?
Shh. What?
You're roaring.
I am?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. It's just, this book is so funny. I had to roar.
Yes, yes. But you're not supposed to roar in the library, remember? You have to be quiet so that you don't bother the other people.
Oh, I see. Yeah, quiet. Yeah, right. Quiet. Okay. Bruh!
Folks. It's okay. It's okay. Come back. It's just the way he laughs.
Oh,
Chicago, you're doing it again.
Oh, I can't help it. This is the funniest book I ever read. I can't stop roaring.
Well, listen, I have a good idea. Why don't you take the book home with you? See, then you can roar as much as you want.
I can take this book home?
Yeah, so you just borrow it and bring it back when you're done.
Oh, wow, that's great. Yeah, I get to borrow the book. I'm so happy I could...
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters D and I, and by the number 13. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Hey, where'd everyone go?
Funding for this program is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.